And moving on now to our big debate this evening. And as we've been saying, Mohan Bhagwat's words, that's the RSS chief, of course, have set the veritable cat among the pigeons. The RSS chief is talking about all Indians' cultural identity being Hindu. He's also giving a message to Modi in a separate speech saying the victory was not a one-man show. Is the RSS raining on Narendra Modi's parade already?
इस ज्ञान के आधार पर आज भी भारतीय बनकर चलने वाले लोगों को सारी दुनिया हिंदू कहती है और उन लोगों को भी हिंदू कहने से समझ में आता है इसलिए भारत को जगह सो गया है हिंदू है और कितनी सरल बात है भाई जर्मन लोगों का जर्मनी है इंग्लिश लोगों का इंग्लैंड है अमेरिकन लोगों का अमेरिका है हिंदू था किसका है
Have the comments made by the RSS chief embarrassed the BJP that insisted through the election campaign that its motto was only development for all? Is this about a larger turf war within the Sangh Parivar? Remember, in a separate speech, Mohan Bhagwat also spoke about the election not being a one-man show, not being one-man's victory. Was that a message to Mr. Modi? Let's introduce our panel this evening. From the BJP, we have here with us a senior leader and spokesperson of the party, Jayant Sinha. Also with me in the studio is Ashish Nandi, well-known sociologist and author. From the Congress, we're joined by Lok Sabha Member of Parliament, Shashi Tharoor, and Professor Rakesh Sinha of Delhi University. Will be with us in just a moment as well. Let me give the first word to the opposition in this case. Shashi Tharoor is somebody who admired Mr. Modi for his first few decisions and said that he was striking all the right notes. What do you make of the RSS comments today that all Indians, when it comes to their cultural identity, are effectively Hindu?
Well, I think Mr. Bhagwat is wrong on at least three distinct counts, Barka, and the first, in fact, is the confirmation that the RSS's mentality is still stuck in the late 19th, early 20th century. There was a time when, for example, in the French language, the word for Indian was indeed Andu, spelled H-I-N-D-O-U, Hindu, because indeed in a couple of languages, everybody living east of the Indus was called a Hindu. But once India became independent, took on a constitution calling itself India, that is Bharat.
Yes.
No one uses that anymore. Even in French now, it's Andien. Second problem is, of course, the constitution of India itself. When you've actually got Bharat as the name of the country, you can speak of people living in Bharat being Bharatvasis, you can't call them Hindus.
Yeah.
And third and most significant is indeed this communal message that Mr. Bhagwat's statement sends, because we all understand the word Hindu to refer to people of a particular religious persuasion. And the signal it sends that this is a country where the only first-class citizens are people who identify themselves as Hindus, and that everybody else lives here on the sufferance of Mr. Bhagwat's view of Hinduism, is not only a travesty, is not only wrong constitutionally, it sends a very dangerous political signal in a country which we are trying to keep united, pluralist, and of course harmonious. I don't think Mr. Modi heading government wants to have actually an important political ally throwing the cat among the pigeons and essentially creating uncertainty amongst minority populations in this country, creating the potential for more conflict and disagreement. I don't think he's doing the government that he has so far have bring to power any favours.
Jayant Sinha, you know, I think Shashi Tharoor makes two or three very strong arguments. One is that there's a factual problem with the etymology of the word Hindu when you locate it within Hindustan. And that is that the word Hindu, as Shashi has already explained, derived from the Sanskrit word Sindhu. It referred to the people who lived beyond the Indus River. It's actually a Persian word, in at least part of its origins. So to conflate Hindustan or Hindustani with Hindus is factually incorrect. And it is certainly, in the minds of many, many people, a communal statement to make. Because what are you telling the Muslims, the Christians, the Sikhs and the other faiths of this country? Has this remark embarrassed the BJP?
Well, we have said consistently, Barkha, that our goal is sabka saath, sabka vikas. So let's be very clear about
that. Because of that, has this comment embarrassed
the BJP? Our Prime Minister has said that India is our religion and the constitution is the holy book. So we are very, very clear in terms of how we think about these issues. You know, I have tremendous respect for Shashi, but I have found that when it comes to this discussion, he sadly always takes it into the gutter. and reduces it to the level of name calling, which I think is not.
What is it that is gutter level, as you call it?
I absolutely think, because I think there is a very serious and important discussion to be had here, and which he himself has been a long time participant in. And that is the question of what is the idea of India as such. And we can have a very good debate and discussion about that. But to say that, you know, what Bhagwatji spoke about today is about religion, and therefore it is violating the way we think about India and violating the constitution, and it is politically dangerous and all the other things that he said, I think is taking it into the gutter. Because
what did the comment mean to you? Okay, if you believe Shashi Tharoor took it to the gutter,
yes, he did.
Let me ask you, what does it mean to you when the RSS chief, no less,
yes,
says that all the people of India,
yes,
चाहे वो किसी की भी पूजा करते हो, he also says that, चाहे उनके कुछ भी रीति रिवाज हो, वो दुनिया भर में हिंदू ही जाने जाते हैं. If Shashi has taken it to the gutter, as you
yes.
said, what does his comment
so
mean
let's,
to you?
let's elevate it from the gutter and
okay.
the stench of the gutter, right?
Okay.
Shashi is a very literate man, as is Professor Nandi here, very erudite, of course.
Yes.
So what's in a name? That by which a rose can smell a sweet. So let's lift it from the gutter and let's talk about what we are really discussing here, and which is the culture of India. And if you use Hinduism, or the word Hindu, sorry, excuse me, what I meant to say was, if you use the word Hindu not to denote a religion, which is consistently what Mohan Bhagwatji has done, consistently what the RSS has done, then we do share a common religion. Which of us would object to that? We do share a common,
common religion.
And I say that
a common religion, if he had said a common religion is Indianness, wouldn't that have been a different argument from a common religion?
That is precisely why I said you're taking it back into the
okay,
gutter.
Okay.
Because you're taking a label and you're denoting it to mean a religion when it actually means a culture.
I think the question, and I'll come back to Shashi Tharoor in just a moment, but Professor Rakesh Sinha,
please, question, I'm itching to answer.
Okay, Shashi, give me half a second. Jayant Sinha says that this remark by RSS chief Mohan Bhagwat is being misunderstood, that he is basically talking about a cultural identity. But a number of people would say, why does that cultural identity have to be located within the context of a religion, especially when the word Hindu in Hindustan actually doesn't refer to Hinduism? How do you read it?
I think Bharka, you just answered your question before coming to that question.
Yes.
I believe that he described Bhagwatji's statement as gutter.
No, 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 he didn't. He said Shashi Tharoor's comments on it.
Shashi Tharoor said gutter.
No. Jayant Sinha was calling Shashi Tharoor's comments taking it. So this was not an attack on the RSS chief. It was an attack on Mr. Tharoor, and he will defend himself shortly.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
Look, the RSS chief.
Shall I do so right now?
No, I'll just let him complete his
RSS chief Mohan Bhagwatji, in
yes.
tradition of RSS ideology,
yes.
He described the Hindu term as a geocultural identity. Hmm. It is geocultural. The term Hindu has been used for the people who lived in a particular land. And
yes, beyond the Indus River or the Sindhu River.
Yes, in course of the time.
Yes.
Barkha, I'm coming. In course of the time. In thousands of years of history of Hindu civilization and culture, this nation, this modern Indian state, which was formed in 1947 or in 19th century, before that, this nation has a big, long history of civilization and culture. And the Hindu is the only term which unravels the continuity of the civilization and culture as a nation.
Professor Sinha, if you were Muslim or Christian or Sikh,
yeah.
or Buddhist in this country today,
yeah.
what would you feel about being told that culturally you are all Hindu?
Yes, they are culturally Hindu.
How do you say that?
If Indonesian Muslims are culturally Hindu, if they are not feeling anything contempt, then why Indian Muslims should feel?
Let me get Shashi and then I'll come to you, Professor Nandi. Shashi Tharoor, you've heard the perspective from both Rakesh Sinha and Jayant Sinha. You know, they will quote also Justice J.S. Verma, widely respected by your party as well, who in his Supreme Court order called Hindutva a way of life. So I think the argument being made here is, don't get literal about the RSS chief's remark. How do you respond to that, Mr. Tharoor?
Well, look, I mean, I think Jayant Sinha has taken the conversation from the gutter to the hole in the ground through which Alice disappeared into Wonderland, where in Alice in Wonderland, they say a word is precisely what I say it means. So Jayant Sinha takes the word Hindu, which is commonly understood to refer to the practitioners of the Hindu faith, and says it doesn't mean that at all. Well, if it doesn't mean that, 90% of the people don't understand what Mr. Bhagwat means. In
they're
that.
Both saying it means a cultural identity. They're saying it means a larger cultural, a geocultural identity, as Rakesh Sinha, Professor Sinha calls it.
Well, and I see this is exactly why I said that Shashi has a habit of taking this discussion into a level that he should
because
he's deliberately misinterpreting this word to mean religion when it does not mean religion.
Okay, your question, Rakesh Sinha's question to Shashi Tharoor.
My question, Mr. Tharoor, my question.
I'm sorry.
India before becoming a modern nation state, what was its status? And I'm quoting Ravindra Kumar, Professor Rajni Kothari, they also call that India is the only nation in the world which is
we have Ashish Nandi sitting here. Shashi, I'll come to you in just a moment. Professor Nandi, is this a debate about the etymology of the word Hindu in Hindustan, or is this a political debate? Are we conflating the cultural discourse around or is there something else going on here that we are missing?
I mean, this is a political debate, no, there is no doubt about it, because etymologically India and Hindu is the same thing.
Etymologically it is,
absolutely.
But the Hindu in India did not mean Hinduism.
But India always, India, great civilizations always has number of names. We were also Jambudip, we were Bharatvarsha, Bharat, Hindustan, Al-Hind, we were all this. We are not concerned with this. I mean, there is no point in raising these issues now.
Yes.
When you say, I mean, this question was raised, why Indonesian Muslims do not feel offended if they call them Hindu, that's because nobody points out to them constantly that it should be important for you
in Indonesia
to declare yourself Hindu, that we are part of the Hindu civilization. They do not say that. We have introduced this sensitivity. Now, this statement will immediately arouse the defensiveness of minority communities. Everybody will feel threatened.
Everybody will feel threatened by this statement?
Yes, absolutely.
Okay. I know both Jayant and Rakesh will want to respond to this. Shashi, I'm just going to let you complete your argument that Professor Nandi says at the heart of this is a political debate. Because, you know, historians can go on arguing about the etymology of a word. Also, the meanings of word changes over time. So, what Hindustani came to mean, for example, under the Mughal empire was not possibly how the word was coined to begin with. Shashi.
Exactly. I mean, to begin with, frankly, and as a believing Hindu, I acknowledge that the Hindus didn't have a term for self-definition. The word Hindu was imported from outside. Yes. Our religion was at best, if you want, Sanatan Dharma,
yes,
or various forms of worshipping specific gods and divinities.
Yes.
But anyway, that's neither here nor there. I'm not interested in the etymological discussion. I'm interested in the political one, which is when you make a statement like that, you are sending a signal in our plural civilization, and you are saying that people who call themselves Hindus have a privileged position in this society. That is the problem and the danger with such a statement. Even with Professor Sinha's argument about geocultural identity and so on,
yes,
the fact is culture is a contested space in any society. There may be certain cultural symbols from Hinduism that other communities are willing to appropriate.
Yes.
For example, the lamp is often lit in Kerala by all communities.
Yes.
But there are Muslims who refuse to light the lamp at secular functions, saying it's a devotional practice. Now, we have to respect their right to dissent from that aspect of our culture.
Okay, Professor Rakesh,
you cannot take one aspect of our culture as the norm and then impose it on those who wish to define themselves differently.
Mr. Tharoor, I don't want to use the
super. And that's why Jayant Sinha's argument is so
sincere. Okay, Professor Rakesh Sinha, I have a question for you and then Jayant.
You are just talking of a lamp. The second oldest mosque in the world, Cheraman Mosque, is in Kerala in your own state, where lamp is, there is a lamp. So it is not the question. Our tradition, is inclusive. And Hindu term, Mohan Bhagwat ji using, it is inclusive. There is an erosion of the.
Professor Saab, couldn't he have said, if he had said, Hum sab Bhartiya, as the song goes from school, no one would have objected. Because Bhartiya or Indian is not associated with one faith.
Barkha ji, he has not negated that you can't call yourself Indian or Bharatiya. Yeah. Just RSS says that Bharatiya and the Hindu words are synonym to each other. And why you hate Hindu to be called Hindu? Why? What is the reason?
Let me finish.
Common sense. We are living in 2015.
Let me finish. Okay. Bharat. The word Bharat. The name Bharat originated from the Kanva Rishi ashram. The Kanva Rishi was Hindu Rishi, and there was a Bharat. The boy was born out of Sakuntala.
Sakuntala.
Then tomorrow someone says someone says that Bharat is a religious term.
So I'll get Professor Anil to respond to that. But
then how many
Jensen,
was
really?
You're talking like grammarian.
Sorry, what are you saying?
He's talking like grammarian. I mean, this is as
not a grammar debate.
I agree.
Yes,
I mean,
first of all, let me ask you this question.
Surely,
I can understand. If some Muslim leader said this, that in one sense we are Hindu Muslims, only 10 years ago, a person sitting in Pakistan in response to a question by India Today said, we are not Arab Muslims, we are Hindu Muslims.
Yeah.
But he can say that and get away with it. Even in Pakistan, I am sure nobody was offended by that.
But
in India, if you say, if Mohan Bhagwat says, on being the head of the RSS, it is like Ku Klux Klan declaring America to be a white country and everybody who stays in America is white.
You are comparing a very wrong comparison. Your basic presumption is wrong.
India is
a multicultural land, diversity.
Professor Sena. I think Barkha was exactly right, and I am very glad that my good friend Shashi has conceded the point, which is that this is not about labels. This is not about the etymology of the word. And as I said right at the outset, there are far more serious things we need to discuss, which is what is the culture of India? Are we?
No, I'm sorry.
Let me finish, Barkha. Barkha, let me finish.
Barkha,
let me say.
Hindustani allows space for other cultures.
Absolutely, and whatever I'm saying, you can use any term that you want. Don't interrupt. It frankly doesn't matter what label you use. No, I'm sorry. Let me finish, Shashi. What I'm saying is the labels actually, at some level, do not matter. We can sit here and get all whipped up in a frenzy and politicize it. But that is precisely what I call the gutter level discussion and discourse that we often
but
have
please
on
TV. Answer my question.
No, there is a much deeper question at hand, which is what we should discuss.
What is the deeper question?
Which is, do we have a unifying culture in India or not?
Okay, Shashi Tharoor, answer
is the
that question.
Question.
Okay, do we have a unifying...
And don't the Americans have a unifying culture? Don't the French have a unifying culture? Don't the British have a unifying culture? Why can't India have a unifying culture?
Okay,
call it whatever you want.
This is an interesting
this
question.
This is a very valuable, this is a very valuable discussion.
Yes, it is.
Because
thank you, Shashi.
The difference between that unifying culture in America, where they have a melting pot, and the lack of that kind of culture in India, where we are a thali, where we are a bowl, we are a dish with number of bowls on it.
I see, Shashi has a habit of playing
with
words.
Which don't necessarily mix with the
melting
next.
Pot.
Okay, let me ask
on salad
let, let me ask Shashi a question. Shashi,
you,
I think the American parallel
to a taste in your mouth.
Shashi,
let me say we have a pluralist society. Where people are free to be Muslim or Hindu or Christian,
I was just
or
going
Parsi
to ask you slightly,
or Sikh or any sect thereof.
Okay, but just to take Jayant's argument further, Shashi Tharoor, I think what he's saying is that the Americans, for example, can have. And in their politics as well, an overtly Christian culture. So if they can have a larger, wider, defining cultural narrative without foisting it on other people, why can't India? I mean, I don't necessarily agree with him. I'm saying that's the question he's placing there, Shashi.
Because we have
is
a different
Shashi
history.
Again?
We have evolved over several thousand years. The Americans have only had 200 or 300. I suspect in 2,000 years they'll be more like us in their acceptance
of
greater diversity.
Good point. They're not as old as
the Germans, the European societies.
Yes.
The Germans and other the Germans. You know, 50 years ago, a German was somebody who was white.
Analogies are wrong.
And
the Chinese have an equally ancient civilization, and they have a unifying culture.
Mr. Bhagwat spoke
about
the
Chinese.
There are people now who are brown-skinned and whose mother tongue is Punjabi and who live in England but are British and not English. So the world is becoming a more complex and diverse place. We have been there for several thousand years. We've had a civilization to which various religions, various ethnic groups have contributed.
Okay,
and that is why our pluralism is such a precious asset. We must preserve and not threaten in the name of a Bhagwat-style uniformity.
Professor Nandi says that today, when you listen to the RSS chief, and if you're not Hindu, because you have a question that you feel insulted being called Hindu, I said no. But what about people who are not Hindu, who are born into another faith? Are we telling the people of India who are not Hindu, who consider themselves of some other religion, that you first have to stand up and be considered Hindu to belong to this country?
Mohan Bhagwat ji is not questioning the mode of worship. You can have a number of mode of worship in the country.
Yes.
Number of communities and the culture. But the geocultural identity is Hindu.
So are they expected
whether you
to say that?
You are free not to accept. Here there is a space. You are free not to accept. But when
you say the geocultural identity is Hindu, what do you mean? Elaborate on that, sir. What do you mean geoculture? Because geographically, it only referred to a river. It didn't refer to a religion.
Right. In course of the civilizational process, what Mr. Tharoor says, it is our civilization of thousands of years old. I say this is the only country in the world which is co-terminous with a civilization. So, how to define this civilization in the nation?
Professor Andi.
Dekhi bhai, I cannot answer this question. This is an absurd discussion. Indian civilization stretches from South Vietnam to Asia Minor. If you look at anthropological work.
Yes.
Do you go and say this to the Indonesians or Vietnamese or Malaysians? You immediately create problems, political problems. We are having a political discussion here. And then saying, I meant it innocently, I was talking only of civilization things, I was only talking of cultural.
What do you think?
I think Professor Nandi is quite wrong.
Let him finish his comment. What do you think he meant? What for you did Bhagwat Ji's
statement mean? This is an old 19th century concept of nationality. Hindus constitute a nationality for India. This is the public religion of India, so to speak. Americans have this. This is what you probably meant. But India is not that kind of a country.
So let me please. Professor Sinha, no, please. You have to.
Okay, Jayant Sinha, then Professor Sinha, then Shashi Tharoor. And I'm running out of time also.
Yes. Yeah. The tragic aspect of this whole discussion is that the folks who speak in this manner are unnecessarily polarizing India when we should be seeking to unify
Doesn't
India.
Doesn't the comment in and, itself and Professor polarize? Nandi.
No, not at all. It's only if you take it that way. This polarization lies in the eye of the beholder. If you want to polarize India, then you can use words like this, speak in inflammatory ways, and polarize India.
On the other hand, you don't think the comment in itself is inflammatory?
Because if you read the words themselves, he says it, and then he very quickly goes into saying, you can call it Bharatiyata, you can talk about all the unifying aspects, you can worship in any different way. But I think it's very important that we first and foremost be Indians, and we have unifying culture.
I'm just mentioning two books, Soul of India by Bipin Chandrapal. Mr. Nandi must have read that book, and Mr. Tharoor also, and Maharshi Aravind, he also used the Hindu Rashtra. That doesn't mean he was depriving Muslims and Christian and other religion from the Indian nationality.
Let me ask you a political question. Do you believe that at a time when the BJP ran its campaign saying development for all, this is our election campaign, do you believe this comment embarrasses the BJP politically?
No, it is not embarrassing. You don't think it makes them look like a Hindu nationalist party? RSS is not a new organization, and it does not make remarks because BJP is in power or not in the power. RSS has been since 1925. It has been pursuing its ideology and ideological campaign, and whether BJP in power or not in the power. And I think BJP people understand what Mohan Bhagwat Ji says. It is those people who don't understand because they fear that Muslim will be threatened, Christian will be threatened. Of course, such kind of fear will go only when such kind of constructive debate takes place.
Shashi Tharoor, are you more convinced than you were in the beginning of this debate?
Not at all, because the entire strength of India, the force, the greatest force for the unity of India, is not uniformity, as Jayant Sinha would have us believe. It is the opposite. It is the existence of diversity.
The words in my mouth, because I never said anything of the sort.
That you can actually be a good Muslim, a good Keralite, and a good Indian all at the same time. Because the Indian identity allows you to be culturally secure in various sub-identities. Mm-hmm. That is what makes India, India. And it will be greatly dangerous if in trying to create some sort of cultural uniformity, we threaten the security people feel in their own identities while being part of the larger Indian
Okay,
identity.
Time just for last comments. Jayant, are you
working? And I think this is precisely what I worry about. The polarization of people like Shashi Tharoor saying that we are insisting on uniformity. Hinduism has never insisted on uniformity. Our culture has never insisted on uniformity.
But Hinduism is not a codified religion, which it is not,
I was mentioning it in a cultural sense.
Why do you need to assimilate other faiths into it? Whoever wants to be a Hindu
We are not assimilating any faiths into it. We are just saying we as a nation, as a civilization have to have some unifying narrative.
He said just before his death in an interview with the Motherland, he said that nature abhors uniformity, and he attacked Europe for the uniformity. So Hinduism and Hindu concept accept the diversity. Without diversity, we can't exist.
Professor Nandi, do you accept this argument that culturally many countries have a what Jayant Sinha in a sense says is a defining culture? and that culture will borrow from
I'm not even saying defining
that's
culture.
What I
said a unifying culture, which is different from a defining culture. There are certain elements of culture that unify.
You're saying Hinduism unifies this country?
I said we have to have a unifying culture. There are Bollywood may be a unifying culture. Cricket may be a unifying culture. There are many elements of culture. It's not necessary that religion should
Professor
be the unifying.
Many of these ideas were taught to us when we are young, because I am much older than you. We were taught this in our schools, that in England is a very unified country. We didn't know that Ireland had already separated. We knew, but we still believed it. That Scotland and Wales always had a nationalist movement and had been accused of sub-nationalism. And now Scotland is going to have a referendum whether it wants to be a different country or not. So this unity is only skin deep often. I don't take it much more seriously, but the nation state system when it came smothered this, and unfortunately our model of state increasingly is veering towards the Savarkarite model. So which was that of a proper
Mohan
European
statement,
nation state.
Sir, last comment on Mohan Bhagwat's statement, Professor Nandi.
I think it is a colonial comment.
A colonial comment.
Last comment.
Okay.
It is the most modern concept, and he says
it's a modern statement.
Hindu nation is an adjective, not an objective. We are using as an adjective of the nation state.
What if someone doesn't want to be defined by that
adjective? Free not to do so.
Acharya J.B. Kripalani wrote a book, Minorities in India. And the same thing he argued there.
Okay, 15 seconds each to Shashi and Jayant, because I'm totally out of time. Shashi Tharoor, last comment.
Look, there are at least 250 million Indians who are proud to be Indian but do not consider themselves Hindu. I do not want them to be excluded from the idea of India, from the vision of India that I would work to fight for and defend.
Okay.
I'm prepared to make common ground with Jayant on the concept of diversity, but not under a label that only some can lay full claim to.
Very
Everybody
good.
Must have equal rights. Shashi's
points are invariably about labels and about names. And I said right at the outset, that is not the purpose of this discussion if you want to have a serious discussion. The serious discussion we need to have is what binds us together as a nation and as a culture. And there are many things that do, and they can be as simple as Bollywood and as simple as cricket. What's wrong with that? The Americans have it. The British have it. The British love soccer.
One sentence. For centuries, other religions and cultures have existed in India in dialogue with Hinduism and enriched themselves and enriched Hinduism too. If you go on using this kind of expressions in public sphere, rub that thing in,
so you're
then
saying
you will see
the dialogue.
In all communities, you have already seen among Sikhs and Jains.
We leave it there. That's an ominous note to end on. Professor Rakesh Sinha, Professor Ashish Nandi Jain, Shashi Tharoor. Sorry, the time is up. But syncretism, I think, of our civilization is something that we should all be proud of. How to find, to borrow that old school cliche, unity in diversity. That's it on the Buck Stops here. Thanks for watching. Good night.